Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome to this tiny garage.
Today, we need to strip the engine. With all of the components still installed, the top of the engine is a confusing mishmash of wires and hoses and sensors. I really had very little idea about what they all did, never mind how to take them apart. With that in mind, I was going to start at the end and show you guys the stripped block. We'll start off with a familiar one here. There's the oil filler tube there, right in the center. Then on the passenger side, we have the oil cooler, which is like a mini radiator just for the oil. On the driver's side, we have the air oil separator, goes on that little pipe there. Then also we have the crankshaft position sensor right on the bell housing. Also on the driver's side close by is the camshaft position sensor. Here's the knock sensor for bank one. The knock sensors are like small microphones that allow the engine computer to hear the engine. If it hears any knocking or pre-ignition, it can change the timing. This is the oil level and temperature sensor. It's a multifunction sensor. And then the pressure sensor for the oil is over on the passenger side. And lastly, the coolant temperature sensor attaches to the coolant manifold right underneath that coolant pipe. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like me to make more, the best way to tell me is to click that subscribe button. Step one, coolant breather hose. A nice easy one to start. A 6mm socket wrench on that fetter to undo that hose clip and then just take it off, nice and easy. Like a lot of the old plastic parts on these engines, the plastic filler tube is a little brittle from its age and it did break when being removed from the car. It got trapped on something. I'm not going to stress about it. That is probably going to happen on some of these plastic parts, and so it's just going to get ripped off and we'll replace it later. The front intake has a vacuum line that we need to undo on the passenger side there. That vacuum line is what runs some of the systems on the engine. Then we need to take off that intake. Those are a bunch of 7mm on the hose clips there. Then just removing that central part of the intake. Next up is the center intake distributor, and that has those 7mm on it as well. Then we need to disconnect the vacuum flap valve in the back. It's like a little butterfly valve that helps the vacuum control how much vacuum it has. Then in the book, it says you're supposed to just take that out now, but there is not enough space. Oh, hold on a minute. We've got some good news. If you guys remember from episode 6, when I was trying to get the engine apart, I dropped that little nut into the mystery of the engine and I found it. Thankfully, it goes back onto the B+ bracket. This viewpoint also makes it easy to see the temperature sensor that we removed to gain access to the third bolt for the air conditioning compressor. The passenger intake manifold is pretty easy now. We just undo those 10mm bolts at its base. And then that center intake distributor can come out now. And then there's that one last 10mm on the intake bracket that the power steering was connected to. And oddly enough, our German car has its intake manifolds made in France. Then I'm going a little crazy with the paper towel just to block all those holes for when I'm cleaning it later. Next is the switchover valve connector. Fuel tank vent connector. We just need to disconnect the electrical connector on the fuel tank vent.
Andy B, thanks for watching.
Over to the other side now, and the driver's side intake manifold just has 6 10mm bolts on it. So that intake manifold does have a little vacuum pipe connected to another switch on it. You have to undo that. Now, when I did that, it did pull it out from the other end. If that happens to you guys, the other end of that Y connects to a Y by the vacuum reservoir down there, that little black round thing. The AOS, or air oil separator, that upper vent line just has to come off so we can remove some of the pipes. The crankcase breather hose is a part of that that connects to the AOS system in the back. You're able to remove those pipes. Okay, the alternator, something I've actually heard of. Now that's the upper idler pulley. You're supposed to loosen that a few turns, and then the other 15mm there, you just remove it. It's a short little 15mm.
Red's on.
Who are those women? Anyway, so that oil filler tube was kind of getting in the way, and it's already broken, so I just chopped it off. And you can see what the deal is here. That bar that was on the idler pulley, you're loosening it enough so it lets go of the block, and then you can whack it to get it to come loose. On the back there is one 13mm connector that goes to the B+ junction box. And then just a regular connector with one of those little clips on it.
Hit the notification bell. It's up there.
Yes, please. Next up is the power steering pump. This was a bit of a mission. So starting off with the 17mm for the front pipe there, you're supposed to counterhold the 28mm next to it. Thankfully, that wasn't necessary. I was just able to undo it and it came out. Next up, these three 13mm are kind of holding on to the pump itself, and there's one extra in the back, and that allows it to move. And it might be possible to get it out then, but I couldn't get it out then. In the back, you're supposed to have a Porsche special tool, which they wouldn't sell me. And I improvised here with a trim tool. You need to push that red washer in while pulling out on the pipe. That's kind of a picture of the special tool there. I did call up Porsche, and that's the tool, that's the part number, but they won't sell it to you. It's for their shop only. At this point, you are supposed to be able to get the power steering pump out from its little house, but I couldn't. It turns out there is an angle it will work, but at this point, I couldn't find it. So then I had to take off the bracket anyway, because it has to come off. And so why not take off the bracket and then take the pump off with it? And so just a bunch of 13mm, but the oil filler tube is connected to that same stand or mount that is holding onto the power steering pump. So we did a couple of 10mm there to remove that. And then liberal whacking with a hammer. It did take quite a lot of whacking. It was on there pretty good, using that pry tool as well. And eventually, success.
Palatino works, thank you.
Okay, the oil cooler, it's in the back on the passenger side. A little bit of WD-40 to try to break through the undergrowth that's surrounding the bolts. Disconnecting the hose clamp on the top with that wonderful Craftsman tool. And then we're just going to go around it with an H5 Allen wrench. And then to finally get it loose, some more WD-40 and some slapping about. Step 17, the Vario cam actuator. On the corners of these heads are a little section with all the plugins for the connectors. There's that one done. And then the crankshaft connector happens to be right next to that. Here's the crankshaft position sensor itself. It's mounted on the side of the bell housing. Here we go, the air oil separator gets removed. Thank you, David Gray, for noticing in a video that my air oil separator looks pretty new. I do appreciate all the comments you guys give me. It's been very, very helpful. The lower vent hose on that one has to come off, and then that's pretty much it. Next, we're going to take off the bracket for the crankshaft position sensor. Now, that camshaft position sensor is really easy to see. It's right in that same area again. Now, with all of that disconnected, we're really just taking this wiring harness from its furthest reach. That's as far as it gets. And then we need to bring it back towards the kind of the front of the car on the driver's side. And then it will zigzag over to the other side of the engine. And that's where it leaves from. It leaves on the passenger side. So here I'm using a screwdriver to push in the connectors on the injectors. It made it much easier to loosen them. So that's all of the driver's side disconnected. Then it kind of zigs over to the other side on a bunch of little brackets. The changeover valve. So in the middle there is this smog system. It needs some power for one of its sensors, and that's what I was disconnecting there. And then marking up some of these sensors, I didn't quite know what I was doing at the time. So just to be on the safe side, I marked that with an A.
Thomas Giazio, thank you.
At the same time, in that same area, we have the knock sensors. So marking that knock sensor, that's a bank one knock sensor with a B. And then the knock sensor for bank two, I marked with a C. Here's that B plus junction box, which now we know actually the other end just goes to the alternator. So I guess it is a pretty important cable, but there's nothing connecting it, so you can remove it. There are a couple of zip ties on this wiring bracket on the passenger side that are stopping the wiring harness from leaving. So now here we are on the other side, taking the wiring harness out from what would be the front of the passenger side. That's the oil pressure sensor there. Just pull those little connectors off. Again, these are the fuel injector connectors. The other thicker wires there are off the coil packs that have long since left the engine. Then there is a wiring bracket in the what would be the rear corner on the passenger side. Very similar situation to bank one. Bank two on the corner has a whole bunch of connectors. So there's the camshaft connector for bank two. Next, we disconnect the coolant temperature sensor. It's located right underneath that large coolant hose where all the pulleys are. Vario cam actuator. These are the little devices that vary the cam timing, and that has a little connector for it. And that's it. All the wiring can leave now. There's nothing for it to connect to anymore. With the wiring out of the way, we now get really easy access to the power steering lines. They're mounted with these little rubber connectors that I WD-40'd and pulled out. The wiring harness bracket. There's no wiring left. We just have the bracket left. One 10mm removes that. And that is all the wiring gone.
Unfortunately, that's all we have for this week.
Thank you for watching.
And action.
Eric, how far? Eric, right?
Eric.
Okay, cool. Okay.
How many like cars can I have left?
Hey, Timothy Throg, how are you doing?
You're the Timothy Throg. What's wrong with the water?
I mean, I cannot even like do it. Like, I don't even know what is this thing for.
It's not a coolant.
Oh, it's not water.
It is not water.
Greetings, okay, fellow
Earthlings.
Underlings, very different.
Bang! Together. Action. 1, 2, 3.
Welcome.
Earthlings.
Greetings.
One, two. Greetings, fellow. No, together.
Yeah.
Greeting, fellows, and.